We're now going to configure IP side connect in the radios. So there are some things that we need to do and things that we need to know. Firstly, we'll need to know the frequencies and color codes of all the repeaters that make up our IP side connect system. Then, once we have that information in the radio, we will need to create groups, so talk groups in the contact lists. Create channels to select those groups so the user of the radio can select the talk group by changing the channel select switch. Then create a thing called an RX group list which points back to the talk groups and the contact list. Then we'll need to create a roam list and point this, or at least point to it, in the channel. So basically what will happen is when you select channel 1, it will use this particular roam list. When you select channel 2, it may use another roam list. It depends on how you want to configure the radio. Once you've done that, then we can look at some of the ergonomics. We'll look at things like the radio IDs and getting all of that sorted. I'm going to start the CPS. And I'm going to open a code plug of a portable radio. So and for this exercise I'm going to use a DP4801. So this is the display model one. So here's the code plug. And you will see that there is a lot of branches of information here. So we have a lot of things in this radio. And in this particular exercise, a lot of them we're not going to use. So we're not going to use things like capacity plus. We're not going to use a select 5 encode or select 5 decode. We're just going to be using basically the channels. We'll be using the roam list. And we'll be using RX group lists and so forth. Anyway, let's start from the beginning. So the first thing that I want to do is I want to go and create contacts. Now I'm not interested in all of these other things over here. So 5-tone, MDC, 1200, quick call true. So to make life easier for myself, what I do is I go in and things like I'm like the 5-tone call one. If I'm not using it, what I do is I rename it and I call it NU. So 6 months down the line, when I read this code plug from the radio again, and I go in and I see something is written, it's called NU, then I know, okay, don't bother going in and looking at anything there. Now the thing that I'm interested in here is the digital contacts. I'm not using capacity plus, so I can leave that out for now. And you will see that I've got already one entry here which is called call 1. And if you look at the icon next to call 1, you will see that it has like a square wave pulse and two little people there. That tells you that this is a group call. So call 1 is group 1, or group ID 1. So you can see there's a number 1. This tells you that it's group call number 1. Now, I don't particularly like that name, so I can change it. You can change it to whatever you want. So to change the name, you right button click and you select rename, or you press F2 from the keyboard. So I'm going to call this one talk group 1. Let me add another one, and you can add by right button clicking here and selecting add and selecting group call, or you can press control plus F7 on your keyboard. So I've got another entry here. You can see the icon looks the same, call 1. Let me rename that, and I'm going to call that one talk group to. The ID in this case is going to be 2. So talk group 1 makes a group call to group number 1. Talk group 2 makes a group call to group ID 2. The next thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to go set up the Rx group list. So here there are a bunch of entries here. I'm not interested in Capacity Plus, so let me call that NU. And I'm going to also leave the flexible. Okay, that you cannot rename. And under the digital Rx group list, I'm going to add another one. So list 1, list 2, and I'm going to rename list 1 to talk group 1. And I'm going to rename the other list, list 2, to talk group 2. Okay, so I've created 2 Rx group lists in the radio, talk group 1 and talk group 2. And guess what? The Rx group list called talk group 1, I'm going to say that the radio has in the members column talk group 1. So the name here and the entry here ties up. Now where does this talk group 1 come from? This comes from the contact list. So if I go back to the digital contact list, that talk group 1 there is this talk group 1 here. So what we are saying is that when the radio is on this, is using this particular Rx group list, is on that particular channel which uses that particular Rx group list, is going to use, it's going to listen to calls made to talk group 1. If I'd done, for example, that, what happens is now the radio will monitor group calls made to talk group 1 and talk group 2. For now, I'm going to remove it, so I'll just say talk group 1. Let's go to the next one, talk group 2, add. Okay. Now, the next thing that I'm going to do is I'm going down to the channels. And we have 2 possibilities for adding channels. We can either add channels that are in the zone. Channels which are in a zone can be selected by the user via the menu or via the channel switch. The other place we can put channels is inside the channel pool. And the channel pool is like the zone, but the user cannot select those channels. So they are like channels that are programmed into the radio, but they are hidden to the user. Now, what I'm going to do in the zone, you will see that there are already 2 channels in there. Channel 1, by the way, is a digital channel, and you can tell that by the little square wave pulse and this knob here. And the analog channel looks like that. You'll see it has a half of a sine wave there. So this tells you that channel 2 is an analog channel. I'm going to delete this channel. You can do that. Right button, select, and delete. Yes. Or you can just select the channel itself and press the delete button. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a digital channel. So to the zone, right button click and select digital channel. Now you'll see that I've got in the zone 2 channels, channel 1 and channel 2. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to rename the channel. Now when you rename a channel or a contact list entry, the name that you put here is the name that will appear on the display of the radio. So in the case of a DP4801, it has a display, so it will show this name on the display. And guess what? I'm going to use so the user, when they change the channel, they will change between talk group 1 and talk group 2. why have I done this? If you come down, you scroll down in the channel and you come here to group list under RX and contact name under TX, you will see that already it's entered there for you, but you'll see that when the radio is on channel 1, what we've now called talk group 1, it will listen, it will RX using RX group list 1. RX group list 1 in this case here is talk group 1, and that is this over here. So when the radio is receiving, it will monitor the groups that are defined in RX group list 1. And if the user presses the PTT when no call is in progress, the radio will automatically set up a group call to talk group 1. And this entry here, this talk group 1 here, comes from your contact list, this entry over here on the left under digital contacts. Let's go to the next channel, channel called talk group 2. You'll see that group list in this case is set to none, so I'm going to change it to talk group 2. I'm going to change this also to talk group 2. So this talk group 2 that you see here is the talk group 2 that is in the contact list. Now there are some things that I need to go do still in the channel, but I'll come back to that in a moment. What I want to do now is I want to create the roam list. I want to create the roam list for these two particular channels. So what I need to do now is I need to add some channels to the channel pool. These two channels here would be the channels from our IP Site Connect system. So let's assume we go back and let's take our one IP Site Connect repeater configuration scenario 1, where you had two repeaters and they were just connected with each other via Ethernet connection. In that IP Site Connect system you see there are two repeaters, repeater 1 and repeater 2. Repeater 1 has a TX and RX frequency, repeater 2 has a TX and RX frequency. And now the radio needs to know about these, and it needs to look at them either by the user selecting the channel select switch or by means of roaming. So to make the radio roam to these two channels, we need to set up a roam list, but in order to set up the roam list, we need to have some channels inside the channel pool. Now, if you have a system, a very simple system like we have in the scenario where there are only two repeaters, two channels, then you don't actually need the second channel in the channel pool. All you need to tell the radio about is about the slot and the frequency of the other site. So if we come back to our scenario 1, we said that on slot 1 is wired and slot 2 is local. So in order for the radio to roam across slot 1, we need to know about repeater 1 slot 1 and repeater 2 slot 1. We don't need to worry about slot 2 because slot 2 does not make up an IP Site Connect system. So it doesn't make sense for the radio to roam between slot 2 of either repeater. We only need to consider slot 1, the wired area slot in our IP Site Connect system. So talk group 1 and talk group 2 can be on the same slot, and they can also use the same channel pool, and we'll see it now, the roam list. Okay, enough talking, let me show you what I'm going to do. So the channel that's inside the channel pool is a repeater channel, And what I'm going to do in here is I need to firstly, let's rename it. Let's call it site 2. Okay. So that's the system that may, that's on site 2, the other repeater, repeater 2. And in the channel, I'm not going to put anything in terms of the Rx group list. I'm going to leave as none. The contact name, I'm going to leave as none for now. There are some things that I need to come back and do some other settings, particularly down here and so forth. Okay. So I have now created a channel in the channel pool. What's important, however, is I need to put in the frequencies of the repeater 2 from our scenario. So the receive frequency was 408.05 and the TX frequency was 413.05. You can go back and check the other video. I believe that's the frequencies, but it would be the repeater frequencies that you would use on your system. These are just example frequencies. So there's the TX and RX frequencies from the system on site 2. What we'd now need to do is to go back to these two channels here and define the frequencies from site 1. So they were 408.025 and 413.025. 408.025 and 413.025. Okay, so now the frequencies are done in all the channels. Now what we need to do is there is one magic tick. Here in each channel, you will see there is a field here called IP Site Connect. When you tick it, it does two things. Firstly, it tells the radio that this channel is a member of an IP Site Connected system. And it also enables this thing here, this messaging delay, a delay that the radio expects for a return message. And you can set this particular value here. This relates to the latency between the sites. So if you have a very simple system like we had in our scenario where you've got two repeaters just connected directly via Ethernet, then 60 milliseconds latency is okay. So we need to tick IP Site Connect in this channel. It tells the radio that the channel is part of an IP Site Connect system. It enables the messaging delay feature in or at least the function in the software of the radio. Not only that, it allows this channel to be added to the roam list. So if I go here, you will see that under this option, under this drop down here, scan stroke roam list, you can see that there is an option here for a roam list. Now, if I go to the next channel and do the same there, you will see that roam list is not available. The reason for that is I haven't ticked IP Site Connect. So if I tick IP Site Connect, it tells the radio, yeah, you can use a roam list on this particular channel. So let me go through, do it one more time over here. IP Site Connect. Boom, boom, boom. So that's all. It's ticked in all three locations. I can now go set up the roam list. I need to go down here to roam list, and I need to create a second roam list. So list 1 and list 2. Why do we do that? Well, if we look at the channels and the zone, you will see that there are two channels in the zone, talk group 1 and talk group 2. So what we need is we need a roam list to allow the radio to roam between talk group 2 and site 2. And we need a second roam list, this one here, for the radio to roam between talk group 1 and site 2. So site 2 is shared between talk group 1 and talk group 2, but we need to have a two separate roam list, because if you don't do that, what will happen if you just have one roam list and all the channels in there, you'll have radios roaming between talk groups, which would end up being very confusing. Now, you can do this, and what I like to do is to rename the roam list. So call the roam list the same as the talk group. So roam list talk group 1 and roam list talk group 2. When the radio is roaming using roam list talk group 1, it should look at channels talk group 1 and site 2. Selected I cannot remove, that's always there. So the radio will always roam on the selected channel, which also means I could probably get away without using talk group 1, but it's probably better we just have it as that. Going on to the other roam list, so talk group 2 and site 2. So when the radio is using the roam list talk group 2, it will roam between talk group 2 and site 2. So site 2 is like the invisible channel in the radio. So the user can only select between talk group 1 and talk group 2, but the radio will automatically choose which channel to use based on the roaming. Now that we've created the roam list, we need to go back to these channels and we need to tell the channel here what roam list it should use. So if we go back into talk group 1 says that we should use roam list talk group 1. Talk group 2 says that we should use roam list talk group 2. Site 2, I don't need to have any roam list here because, well, what do you put there? Do you put talk group 1 or do you put talk group 2? It becomes a little bit more confusing. So it's probably easier just to leave it as none. Okay, so now I have the two channels. I have the roam lists. I can now concentrate on the ergonomics and the IDs and tidying up the other things in the code plug.